G'day, Glenn Morris from the Smart Energy Lab. Today, I'm looking at some Jinko panels. I recently mounted a couple of panels on a trailer, and also there's a Jinko panel behind me on what I call my solar museum. This is the 430-watt N-type, but if you really want to go for the maximum density on your roof, why not go really big? So for the residential market, Jinko have panels that go up to 470 watts. Who knows, next week it'll be something bigger. But you know, considering that the average system size in Australia now is something like 8 kilowatts, you really need to get some big panels on your roof. Now, for the installers out there, they're going to be going, oh my God, they're so heavy, they're so big. But actually, it's the life of installing equipment, whether it's sheets of plywood or form ply, things get, you know, they have a weight and you need to deal with that. So you need to have safe strategies for lifting heavy weights and putting them onto roofs. Now, when I say heavy, you're talking less than 30 kilos, but it's still quite large at 1.7 meters by 1.3 from memory. So it's important to do it right and not risk your back or the safety of your colleagues and co-workers. So here I am at the Smart Energy Lab, standing in front of our solar trailer. Now, this solar trailer here has had quite a few lives. We've built it with different panels over the time. And at the moment, it's got two 470-watt Jinko panels, N-type, with the half-cut cells. Now, when you do the sums, it's not very complicated. 470 times two is 940 watts on a trailer. Now, I'm a bit of an old timer in this industry. I remember putting up 1 kilowatt systems were 8 panels, and that was considered a big system. In fact, used to get large rebates for a 1 kilowatt system. These days, 2 panels is almost 1 kilowatt on a trailer. But what are we going to do with this? Well, actually, we're going to use this as a adjunct to a tiny house. We're going to basically use this as the power station for a tiny house. So it's not just the solar panels, but it's also the whole power station. So what we got in here is the Victron multi-grid, the 3000 watt unit, 48 volt. We've got 4 12-volt monoblock lead acid batteries. Now, you know, people think lead acid's days are gone. Well, actually, they're still used a lot in industrial applications, commercial applications. And this one has got a feature known as a balancing system. So it's kind of making lead acid smart. That's pretty cool, using something known as the BAX system. So what we've got here is actually individual monoblock balancing for what is effectively 4 12-volt modules in series, or 4 12-volt monoblocks in series. And therefore, they're being monitored to have the same voltage in the string, but also their temperature and their health is being reported. So if one of these starts to fail, I get an email. To continue the system here, we're using the Victron beautiful GX color controller. I just love GXs. They're one of the best ways of monitoring a power system. From a customer's perspective, really simple to understand, moving diagrams, we're showing the power flow, and a lot of it's self-detected too. Certainly if you're using products, I know with Fronius, it just automatically finds a Fronius inverter. We've got an MPPT here, so this is a 150 volt input maximum, 35 amp output maximum. So we're just squeezing it there a little bit. I think we'll be getting pretty close to that with our 470 watts of panels, but it does have a limiting factor at 35 amps of output current. So that's the solar trailer here at the Smart Energy Lab. But what's going to come up next is connect it to a tiny house. And I'll probably link it up here in the card. Why would we use a trailer for a tiny house power system? Well, there's not a lot of roof area on tiny houses, and sometimes you need that for other things, like hot water, or even just the roof is too short to put large panels on it. And that's the case here. The tiny house is actually a very short length pitch of roof because it's got a east-west or north-south to be exact pitch on the roof, and we can really only get panels in landscape format, and that limits us to a maximum of about 4 200-watt panels, which is a total of 800 watts. But using these Jinkos on this trailer, we can get more, 940 watts on a trailer parked in the sun. And that's the other big advantage, is that with a tiny house, you often want to plant it somewhere where it's not necessarily in full sun. It might be protected from the wind, might be protected from direct sunlight if you're in a hot climate. But using a trailer as the power station, you can pop it out in the sun and run underground power or temporary above ground power back to the tiny house. So let's check it out. Here we are in front of a tiny house here at the co-op where the Smart Energy Lab is built. This is actually one of the residents on the co-op, and she's been living here for many years. She's had a very small power system. Let's go and check it out. It's really just four panels. Two of them are pretty interesting. Two of them are what's known as PVT, photovoltaic thermal, which means that they can heat water as well as generate electricity. And you can see behind me the solar panels on the tiny house. Now, remember I said that there's not a lot of roof area on a tiny house, so she's got really just room enough for four panels in landscape. And so there's two PVTs, photovoltaic thermal, that means they can heat water as well as generate electricity, and there's two conventional monocrystalline 200 watt modules, so a total of 800 watts in a string connected to a inverter and some lithium-ion batteries. But what we're going to do is add out in the sun, because you see part of the system's in shade right now, a trailer-based power station with a temporary or underground feed to this tiny house. Now that's going to happen at a later date, and I'll link it up here in the card when we do it, but we'll see how that goes. It'll also add to her system, so she'll get the existing batteries will be her primary source and her existing panels, but she will have this sunny and extra storage system upstream of her existing system. And that means she can have quite a big system for a tiny house. It's coming close to 2 kilowatts. Anyway, we'll check this out when it's built at a later stage. Thanks for watching.